Join the ranks of these greats. Become a member of the IGFA today. For more information, visit IGFA.org.
There's nothing that's more fun than fishing, the joy of fishing. And you meet such wonderful people, all sports enthusiasts, the kind of people we all love to know, the people we enjoy the most. I recommend fishing wholeheartedly.
In an era when lady anglers were considered distractions and often found themselves relegated to shore, Kay Rybovich helped make it possible for women to participate in the male-dominated angling world and prove they were worthy adversaries. It was a radical concept. Kathryn Jordan moved to Palm Beach, Florida from New Jersey in 1924. On her first date with John Rybovich Jr., they went fishing. Kay caught her first sailfish. She was thrilled and anxious to show it off. And John released it. Billfish conservation was one of her husband-to-be's passions, and it became one of hers as well. Of the hundreds of sails she caught, Kay brought in only two, one of which topped the West Palm Beach Fishing Club's summer contest and earned her a gold button. In the winter of 1955, Kay and friends Denny Crowninshield and Ginny Sherwood realized they were weary of being excluded from tournaments, of fishing only on Ladies' Day. It was time for their own group and their own competitions. The first meeting of the International Women's Fishing Association was held in April 1955, and within 2 months, there were 100 members. Most men still doubted women had the strength, stamina, and skill to handle the big fish, but it wasn't long before the IWFA ladies set the record straight. Invited to the 1956 Hemingway Marlin Tournament in Cuba, Kay, Denny, and Ginny became the first female team to fish an international event, and they took second place. The following year, the IWFA team won the Hemingway, besting the world's top anglers. Soon, tournaments were organized in Palm Beach, in Mexico, and then worldwide. Attracted to the IWFA by the fishing, camaraderie, and opportunity to make a difference, members have been leaving their mark on the sport for more than half a century.
Well, it's more than we even dreamed of when we first started it. We were hoping. We had such high hopes for it. And when it developed, just like we're saying, it always was so wonderful to know that and to be sharing it with people who were just as enthusiastic as we were. It was happy, and everybody reporting their catches and comparing notes on the fishing and how the experiences they had and what happened to them that day out there and the usual things that do happen aboard boat, you know. And I can't recommend anything more heartily than let's go fishing.
Instilled in the organization is Kay's personal conservation ethic. When most anglers were bringing everything back to the dock, the IWFA was promoting catch and release. A scholarship trust was established in 1965, and in 2004, the creation of the Kay Rybovich Trophy recognized her contributions. A master bridge player, patron of the arts, and passionate fundraiser, Kay is vivacious and charming. Recognized as the power behind the throne, she worked tirelessly, both out of the limelight and together with John, and the couple's legacy of conservation continues to this day. A 1955 article in the New York Times began, "Women Anglers Organize, Militant Group in Fight Against Tournament Ban." The piece described an extremely militant organization formed in bitter opposition to various national and international angling tournaments in which only the stronger sex may compete. There is little doubt that article brought smiles to the faces of the IWFA founders. The IGFA Fishing Hall of Fame takes great pleasure in recognizing one of them, Kay Rybovich.